Breaking news, take it easy. Yoruba scholars sends a strong message to Sunday Igboho. Hello, my wonderful people. We all know the tension already building up, in case you're not aware, towards the July the 3rd rally that will be happening in Lagos. Why is the one of Lagos so, building up so much dust? Remember that Sunday Igboho has been to Akure, that is Ondo State. He has been to Oyo. Yes, Seyi Makinde, the governor of the state, gave security. What about Ekiti and Osun, Ogun? But guess what? Why is Lagos just such a big deal? It is because the Ajigaba of Lagos, who is not the governor, is not the chief security officer of that state, however, has positioned himself in such a way that if you have to come to this part, you have to go through me, if you get what I mean. And I've said that they do not stand for section from Nigeria, and everybody should keep clear. Even the commissioner of police in Lagos have said anybody who comes to take rally will be dealt with. Please don't forget to give us a thumbs up. Subscribe if this is your first time. Let's get the details. A conference of Yorubas has urged Sunday Igboho and other pushing for section to take things easy and see it from broader perspective. A conference which had in attendance Yoruba scholars and traditional rulers was led by Professor of History, University of Texas, Houston, Toyin Folola. The Yoruba leader and scholar met at Brooklyn University, Remi Ogun State, on Monday for 6 agenda lectures and conference on Yoruba culture and society. Speaking at the event, Professor Folola stated that what Nigeria needs was decentralization of power to allow the 6 political zone in the country to have the autonomy to function. He said decentralization will solve most of the problem, including the insecurity facing the country. Folola said the Yorubas are angry, the Igbos are angry. So how to minimize and reduce the anger is what we must find a solution to. It's good to see lectures. Please, I just have to interject, please. Lectures is good. Solutions are good. You have to be at the top to implement this. Buhari told us a few days ago that people should forget about anything called restructuring. This autonomy of power. He said people should forget about it. Things will remain the way they are. He said Yorubas can go. Igbos are a dot. They can go. That the Hausas are the real owner of Nigeria. So I don't get it. You guys are just sitting somewhere having some wonderful lectures, AC blowing you if there are any, if there's lights to power the AC. And you come out and just tell us that they shouldn't. Excuse me. Talk is cheap. Work and actually getting to the crux of the matter is what matters. Let's continue. At this time, the best advice one can give is decentralization and autonomy of power in various regions. I don't think separation is the best way to go, but seeking better autonomy in this region is a better option. Ola Tayo Adesina, another professor of history, in his submission advised the agitators of the Yoruba nation to think through what they are asking for. He said, those who are pushing for it, I will like to say, let it be known that they should take it easy and look at it from a broader perspective, because here the structure of Nigeria is such an imbalanced situation, and we really have to do and think right and do the right thing. Sunday Igboho, who is clamoring for this, needs to sit down with other people and call for peace rather than destroying what belongs to us. We need to be patient, tolerant, and bear with other ethnic groups. It was a 3-day conference held in the Yoruba Culture and Social Society, and many nationalities, international scholars, Yoruba culture speaking about all that they want to do in the forthcoming days. So, like I earlier reiterated, You see this word called talk. Very cheap. Anybody can talk. Let's talk, let's talk, let's talk. That is the same talk or words that they used to bamboozle us. Have we forgotten? 2015. Nigeria is going to be better. These people you have today do not mean well for you. We are the ones who mean well. We are going to ensure that you have the best. You are going to enjoy the dividends of democracy. Can somebody relate with that? You and your children, even the ones who have not finished school, we see what it means to have a nation. We will do A, B, C, D, Z. And Nigerians were like, oh, finally, one who sees and understands the problem, understand the political terrain and what we are going through. Probably they've got a solution. Let's tag along. My dear, now tag along with this. So let's tag along. And the greatest mistake again was 2019. As if 2015 was not bad enough. When somebody has made a mistake, there are rooms for correction here and there. There are rooms for error. Even in a, what's it called now, there's what we call error margin. That is where you give allowances for, it could be wrong here and there, irrespective of how much you've done. However, I don't think we really learned very much. We didn't. We got on the boat again in 2019, whether it was us or they announced that they won, no, we don't know which one. But today, we are in that position where we are saying, oh my God, how did we just get here? How did we ever get here? So this is what it is, my people. This is what is happening. You want Sunday Adeyemo to take it easy. It's all right to take it easy, but not when you see children that should be in school, intelligent young boy, no opportunity. The mother is sick because there is no medical attention, the same medical attention they promised women and children. And so the mother dies at the boy is still a very young boy. And what does a child, how does a child look after his or herself? So here comes this people who seemingly wants to help introduce him or her into gangs, armed robbery. That same child ends up in prison. So what have you done, really? Have you solved the problem? We need to go back to the basis. We need to address it. We need to call a spade a spade. We should stop giving ambiguous statements because they sound right or they sound good or that's what people want to hear. We must definitely do more. That's the only way we can really thrive as a people. Other than that, we're wasting our time. Leave us a comment. Please don't forget to like us, share, subscribe. Click on the notification button so you can get all our latest news. God bless you. Bye for now.